right. Oh, I can hear myself because I left the audio on because I'm stupid. Wait, where's that even coming through? Oh, there we go. Right. I have two browser windows open. It's fine. It's all good. Fixed it. Okay. Right. So I've gone live. So, yes. So good morning, everybody. Good morning and welcome. Welcome indeed to your Wednesday. If you're in Europe at all, I hope you're coping with the heat. For those who aren't in Europe, turns out we've had this rather weird weather system. According to the BBC Weather, we've had this front come up from, like, the Sahara Desert or something, which is, it's giving us lots and lots of warm, like, muggy air so it's very uncharacteristically hot over here in Europe, and the UK is getting a good chunk of it. Not really to the north at the minute, but certainly to the south, where I am, it's as warm as it is in Portugal, which is like, ugh. So I hope you're having a lovely morning all the same, and I hope you're able to stay nice and cool. The weather might be loud. The music might be a bit too loud. I'm just going to turn that down. there we go. Right. So that's the overlay. That's the game. Yeah, you guys can see it. And that's a greedy animal that just eats all my food. Yes. Who's a greedy animal that eats all my food? Yes, she is. That greedy animal is going to get more food because that's what you do. Food goes in one end and poop comes out the other. Yes. Right. Thank you, Crisis and Pharos. Thank you, both of you. That's very kind. Yes, indeed. And stay hydrated, folks. Thank you, Holy Imperator. Thank you, sir. So, as people trickle into the stream, just to get you up to speed with what's currently happening on the YouTube side of things. Oh, sorry. The audio has reset itself to max volume again. Hang on. There we go. OBS does that sometimes. On the YouTube side, on the streaming side of things, I'm just going to be playing a bit of Factorio. The guys of ZF are currently building a factory here, so we have a rather large factory floor on this death world, and we've been building and contributing towards the entire thing gradually. Thank you, Shazbut and Alistair and Gallant. Thank you, all of you. And good morning, Alistair. I hope you're well. We've just been building away in Factorio, and no real plan, I suppose. We're just kind of playing because why not? We just got in the mood to pick it up again. And on the YouTube side of things, I'm currently... Yeah, so it's the third week of work on Armor Bullshittery Part 10. So far, so good. It's nearing its completion. If you're a patron or a Twitch sub, I sent you an email yesterday? Question mark? Was it Monday? Sorry, I can't recall. I sent you an email concerning my progress, and I will endeavour to get the video to you guys as top priority as my backers as soon as I can. So please keep your eyes on your email. I will send it to you, and then I'll be about to answer any questions and get your feedback, and hopefully it pleases you. And after which, I'm going to get on with the next bullshittery, which it's a bit of a sore point for me. I've got numerous projects that are incomplete. I've got about 12 projects that are sitting on the back burner. Most of them are video essays, but one of them is a cartoon. I wanted to do a cartoon in a sort of Dungeons & Dragons-esque fantasy thing that we played Dungeons & Dragons, basically, and I thought, hey, I'll do a cartoon out of this. Turns out it is incredibly hard. It is the hardest thing I've ever done, phrasing. It's very difficult. So I've been trying on and off over the last couple of years, but yeah. The reason I'm saying this is that I'm having some good fortune. The artists that I've been commissioning have been doing great work. So I've been getting assets back, and so far they're great. They're really good, and I'm looking forward to starting to puppeteer them around in this cartoon, which is what I'll be doing next project, basically. So short version is Armor Bullshittery is still being worked on its third week. Normally takes me about 3 to 4 weeks to finish any given 10-minute project. And then the next bullshittery is a cartoon, which I'm hoping, fingers crossed, will be interesting. Even if it fails, you know, at least it'll be interesting to present. We'll see. Is Cyanide playing with me? No, I just can't get him to get Factorio. He's just not interested at all. Thank you, D. Calyx. Thank you very much. Yeah, Science said he's not interested in building. He likes, in the same way he doesn't play Minecraft and stuff, he doesn't like building, he likes destroying. Thank you, Tippity. Thank you very much. Yes, Alistair, it's way too warm. Also, the flat, because of all the bins and stuff, I empty them frequently, but because it's so warm, everything's just smelling. It's just this horrible mugginess. It's not nice, is it? Right, okay. So, what's next? What's the next step for the factory? So we've just finished a research project, which is worker speed, so the drones. Worker robot size. So these are logistics drones. Character logistics slot. Did we ever finish the Roboport? Roboport. We did. Okay, that's super important. So let's start the next one, which will be worker robot cargo size. So what's happening there when I click that research button is that over here, I'll show you by the satellite, we have a number of, we have research row, which consists of a number of research domes, which are processing vials. So a green, red, and blue, and white. And they're being dragged into these research domes where they're whirring and causing this to go up. So all we have to do is provide the vials. The vials, however, require an increasingly complicated list of ingredients to manufacture. The red being quite simple, the green being a bit more complicated, the white being tricky, and the blue being a bit of a nightmare. And as you see, we've gradually ramped up production. So that's blue, that's white, green, and red. Thank you, Rambos and Teapot. An Energizer, and Jack is the best brother. Shut up. And Tippity. Thank you, all of you. That's very kind. Thank you. How am I dealing with the heat? Not very well. I don't like it. You can go away. Cool. So it looks like blue could certainly be increased. So yes, there's certainly room for more efficiency. So what's this? So he's bought in a solid... Yeah. Wow. Oh, no. He's... Okay. Well, I guess it's a stopgap. So he's gone and siphoned off a portion of the solid fuel, and he's taken it via conveyor all the way down here. He should have taken it by train. We have another opportunity for a station here. He should have put in a train. Oh, well. Sorry, what is that? That's a coal? Oh, I see the coal field. Right. Yeah, Tom did that. Okay. That's fine. So he's just exploiting a nearby coal field. So yes, but here we have another opportunity for a station to be dropping off solid fuel. Right. Okay, so what's my next task then? Good. At least we're churning through the blue research, so I should just keep it going. Better pylons. We'll definitely do that. Okay, so what's my next step? The personal roboport, almost certainly. So, good, there we go, I just need cogs. So I've just ordered my suits fabrication system to give me a personal roboport, which is going to let the drones, which are floating about, dock with me. So they will attach to my armor and recharge themselves and also fetch things for me. I'll basically have a bunch of sort of familiars in the form of robotic drones that squeak and squawk and fly around and do my bidding. Loyal drones, loyal synths. Right. Would I ever play games on Steam with my brother? My brother doesn't really do much gaming these days. He's now a family man. He's got a son, and he's married now. Hang on a minute. This music has talking in the back. What do you want, sweetie? What do you want? What's this about? What's this about? What's this about? Huh? Yes, who's your good dog? Yes, you are. Who's so good? Yes, you are. Yeah, she's okay. She's just come back from her walkies. Yes. We went to the pet shop, didn't we? What's that? Is that a treat? Yeah. Yeah, there we go. She is satisfied. The beast accepts the tribute. Right. So get the roboport going and then attach it to my armor. Let's see if... So hang on. So this is my armor layout. Move these solar panels over here. Take off two of the batteries and place them here. Where's the roboport? Here it is. So a personal roboport. Electricity... is currently okay. 10 robot limit. So if I take 10 drones in my inventory, they'll fly around and do whatever I want them to do personally. Okay. Yes, but they will recharge on me, no one, and do my bidding. Right, okay then. Stand by, we got a proximity alert. Walls have been breached. The bugs are trying to chew their way through the outer wall of the of the iron ore facility. Okay, keep researching, keep going. Advanced material processing, the electric furnace. Trains can slow down faster, allowing them to stay at higher speeds for longer. Just research that. Nice, we've got crude oil turrets. They're just firing flammable crude oil. Yikes. Okay. So then, what's my next step? Roboport. Drones, I guess. We've got to get drones. Now, has anybody built a drone manufacturing area? We had a very temporary and pretty shit one over here. It was a bit hodgepodge. But now that we have decent red circuits over here, we should actually get this going properly, shouldn't we? Okay. Thank you, Nim. Thank you, sir. And a Google U. Thank you, Google U. Okay, that will be my task then. Let's get some drones going. Novi builds drones every day. What? Also, good morning, Novi. Oh, fuck. All of our construction drones have been torched. So we have 28 logistics drones, but no construction drones. They've been killed by the bugs, which is a problem. Well, that explains all of the yellow alerts. The turrets are calling for repairs, but we have no repair drones to satisfy that. So it won't be long before the bugs chew their way through the walls. Okay, very urgent then that I get drone production operational and automated. Okay, so that's the train brake research. Character logistics slot, we'll do that now. Okay, so what will we require for the drones? So here they are. So construction drones will require, so it's advanced and basic circuitry and flying robot frames. So the circuits are easy, they're all just available here off the main bus. Might need to make a dedicated green circuit area for the main bus, but yeah, but at least it will be in this area. Damn, we need more space. It needs to be over here really, doesn't it? Unless I divert a section of it up here. Okay, I'll divert a section of it up here. Right. Oh, bugs are piercing the wall there. Right, so circuits are easy. So what about the... hang on. So flying robot frames will require steel from the main bus. Batteries. Right, so we need to provide a few things on the main bus. So green circuits and batteries. Certainly. That's what we should do. So, yeah, that's the priority then. So let's assign. So you see these big lines here? This is what's known as the main bus. It's effectively consider it a main artery for the beating heart that is your factory. So from here, the forges feed this main bus, which just supplies steel and copper and stone and coal that's not coming from the forges, but you know what I mean. So all of this will flood downstream quickly to supply the rest of the factory. So what we're going to do is we're going to provide large facilities up here, which are going to feed green circuits and might be worth moving the red circuit one further up. And also batteries. All of those will be needed on the main bus. Don't get hit by a train. This might be a good place to do that, actually. Alternatively, we could set up a small satellite facility to do nothing but provide green circuits. En masse. That might be a good idea. But then again, I've got to get some repair drones up now. Otherwise, the bugs are going to get through the walls. Thank you, Black Shadow. Thank you very much, Black. Okay, let me just get back up to that other smaller facility and feed it some basic resources to at least get some construction drones here. Thank you, the intellectual cat. Thank you. Yes, I'll let the drones catch up with me. They're delivering some walls. Thank you, boys. No electric furnaces currently. We've only just finished researching them, I believe. Oh, we don't require this anymore. This is an old blue vial manufacturing facility, which is now no longer required. So deconstruct this section here, if you please. This will order any available construction drones, not that we have any, to come over here and clean that up and take all of its resources and dump them back in the, dump them back in the storage containers. This music, I don't know actually. Sorry, what is this music? This is Solar Fields Green. It's an album that was just on my recommended for YouTube. I listen to lots of ambient type, I'm not sure how to describe it, like ambient, non-vocal type music, like carbon-based life forms, that sort of thing. Oh good, 33 robot frames have already been manufactured for me. So let's turn all of these into construction robots. Yeah, there we go. Good, 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 good. Thank you, Zekis. Thank you sincerely, sir. Thank you. Right, so, and while we're here, we'll just, so that's not required. Well, it is. Hang on. So give this some so put plastic in here. This will provide red circuits if we need them. Yeah, I'm not sure how to describe it, Alistair. Just, this is going to sound like old fogey speak, but fuck it, you're used to it. I find that when people are singing, they're kind of singing over the music, if that makes any sense. Like, sure, sometimes vocals are all well and good, but, like, rap music, for example, oh, I abhor it. It's just, you know, just play the music. Just let the rhythm, the beat, the music, stop talking over it. Yeah, I know that sounds incredibly old and like, yeah, I'm aware of this. I just want to listen to the music. Back in my day. Hello, sweet pea. Hello, my darling. How are you doing? Who's your good dog? Yes, you are. Who's my good dog? She wants attention. Right. Right, again, I keep mentioning this. I would like to show you my rod. Sorry, bear with me. I'm just going to show you. I do this joke every time. I'm going to show you my rod. I'm going to get out my black rod. Oh, there we go. Oh. Yeah. So basically, I used to play with my rod a lot when I was 14, but it was much smaller back then. But now I've got a much larger one. Ah! Ah! Yeah, well, this is only about half of it, so it's a 12-footer. It's not, well, obviously, you see it attaches on the end there. But, yes, I used to go fishing when I was about 14. I got one of those, tackle sets, like a gift for a Christmas present or something. And it was all very cheap. It was like a plastic telescopic rod that wouldn't last very long. But I was able to sort of scrape together and get borrowed equipment. But the trouble is, when you're 14, for a hobby such as angling, which is quite an expensive thing, all the equipment is just ridiculously expensive, I was very quickly priced out. I couldn't even afford the fishing licenses once I reached the age necessary to get one. You know, if your pocket money is £10 a month or something, and a fishing license costs 30 quid, just the license, none of the gear, which you lose gradually as you fish, you'll lose line, you know, it will start to become shit. So yeah, I was priced out. But I thought that now that I'm older and I've got an income and I would like to have a few more hobbies that require me getting out of this flat, I thought I might try it again. So yeah, I picked up a rod and I've got a reel. I've also bought a tackle box. It doesn't have any tackle in it. So I'm just going to gradually order it bit by bit. And when I think I'm ready, I'm going to go out on a fishing lake, like a fishery, and go. Go give it another go, really. But it's been 17 years since I was last fishing, roughly. So, you know, I was a different person back then. So I think I need to act as if I'm just a complete noob that doesn't know what they're doing. I've done loads of fishing, but again, when I was 14, a different person entirely. Hello, Lulu. Well, uranium would be useful. Squirrel-woodle. Definitely, and that needs to be a priority for the base. But right now, I've noticed that all of our construction drones have been destroyed. What's this? Low density structure. Spaceships. What the fuck? Ooh. Right now, all of our construction drones have been nuked, so I'm just trying to get a bunch of them restored. So I have 33. So if I just deploy some of them into the network, keeping about 10 for myself. Wait, now, how many can my Roboport manage? Let's keep... Yeah, just keep 10 for myself. Because the logistics drones can go and... yeah. So how many do we have in the network? So these the orange squares represent the logistics network. The green represents the building network. So we now have 23 construction drones, and they're all busy. Okay, they've flown off to go... Yeah, they've taken repair kits, and they're off to repair walls and turrets. Right. Well, that's something. And this factory is continuing to churn out fresh ones. Requires more engines. Okay. Right. It tells you how many you can handle if you hover over the power armor. Yes, so it says, is it 10 to start with? What does it say? Yes, Roboport. No, wait, 10 divided by 2. What? Oh, no, that's the dimension. Hang on. Oh, robot limit 10. Charging stations on my suit, 2. Okay. Well, that's good. Okay, so now, if I just demonstrate what I just... You know how I just designated that whole area for deconstruction? Watch this. My drones will be deployed from my suit and will do it themselves. So they will now deconstruct things quickly without my interference. All I have to do is just sweep my hand over an area and it will be removed. I can also place down storage boxes, which the drones can access. And if I place surplus resources that I don't really care about, the drones will, well, take these and use them elsewhere in the facility if they're requested. Thank you, Lord Shilamachen. Thank you sincerely. What's that, sorry? Build the personal Roboport stack. By the way, the personal Roboport stack. Do they really? Is that the case? Holy shit, if that's the case, that's cool. Let's build another one then. I don't know if my suit power can handle it before I'm still using solar power. I don't have like a nuclear engine or anything. Sorry, just got to keep my eye on the alerts. So we don't have any walls completely penetrated. What are my top 10 games? I don't know, but I'd certainly say that Factorio would definitely be in there. It's very good. Thank you, Jolly. Thank you very much, Jolly. Okay, they're just bringing me solid fuel. I don't really care about that. Let's take that manually. Get rid of that chest and stick it all in here. The drones will know what to do with that. Yes, I'd say RimWorld as well. But my top three, as in my favourite game, I couldn't decide on which one, so I picked three, would be Startopia, Dungeon Keeper, and Myth the Fallen Lords. Three of my favourites. Why does ZF not play Payday 2? We played it briefly. It wasn't that great. It's alright. Nothing to really phone home about. Oh, wait. The drones are suffering. Oh, my suit has no power. Okay, so I take it during the... Yeah, they drained all the power that quickly. Yep. Put down another battery. And then just fill the rest of the space with portable solar panels. What do you want, Lou? Lulu wants attention. I've just got to ignore her. Right, well, the robots will do what they'll do. So I need to... So, yeah, at least the drones are up and running. No! Fuck! Oh, I see. This is the problem. That's how they're getting destroyed. Right! The construction drones are trying to fly. Why would they go that way? That's how they're getting nuked. There's a nest here that's taking them out. Right, let's deal with that then. One problem after the other. So, yeah, we're just going to lose all of them. We're down to 17. Yeah, that's how they're getting taken down. So let's build a tank. Where are the tanks? Tank, 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 tank. Where are they? Am I just being blind? Trains, car, tank. There we go. Cool, I can build one. So I'm going to go build a tank. Let's go and get high explosive ammunition. There's none in this box. Dynamite, good. What does it require? Plastics and steel. It's not being fed plastics nor steel. There we go. Now it is. Have I played around with the circuit network? No, Philip, I haven't really messed with that much. Why is that not providing? Huh? What's gone wrong here? There's someone... Do it manually. Okay. So some high explosive shells are being assembled here. They'll be ready in a minute when my tank is ready. Okay. Some badly damaged construction drones are limping back home. They're just trying to fix the walls down here. Yeah, so that's the problem. We've got nests that are creeping way too close. Right. The long inserter was too close to the chest. Oh, is it really? I think I've done that. I think I'm a dumbass. Well, we know I'm a dumbass. What am I doing? What's wrong with this picture? Oh, does it just not require them? There we go. It's cool. Alistair contributes and says he has no experience with long inserters. Thank you, Alistair, for your comment. You cunt. Bugger off. Go to a stream or something. Go milch cows or whatever it is you do in Somerset. So yes, for those just joining the stream, just playing a bit of Factorio this morning. No real plan. On the YouTube front, I'm working on Armor Bullshittery Part 10. And it's week 3 and it's going fine. Actually, it's all good. I'm hoping to have it with to you as soon as I can. And in addition, I've been doing some, sort of preliminary work. Well, I've been working with some artists who I'm commissioning for a cartoon that I want to make. But it's so hard. It's so hard. I'm trying, but it's very, very hard. Okay, so do I have the tank? I believe I do. So I'm just going to drive south and... Oh yeah, can I put that second roboport? Oh yeah, I wanted to stack them, but... We'll just go with the solar for now. Maybe switch off the night vision? Take out the night vision and just put the roboport there and see what happens. Is my power recharged? Well, it's nighttime right now. Okay, so down here... Do we have like a... We don't have an outer gate. Can I build one? Yeah, I'm just going to build like a gate bit here. So people can come back and forth. How are you doing, Alistair? Are you okay? Why don't I play Gmod with ZF? We did. Yeah, we have. We had fun. We played Prop Hunt. There was a ban on the fucking hula doll. It's bullshit. I'm sorry, if you don't know what Prop Hunt is, effectively you join a map in Gary's mod, which is the Half-Life 2 mod, and it's just full of props, so it's full of junk everywhere. Every room is full of chairs that are stacked up and watermelons in bowls and just, you know, rubbish and stuff. And the idea is that you can look at an object and turn into it. Your character physically turns into a prop. And it's a game of hide and seek in which the characters are a humanoid and in first person mode must try to figure out exactly which props are fake and which ones are real. And they shoot the prop, and if it's obviously a person, then they die, they get shot. But if it's a prop, then the person takes about, I think it's 10% damage. So you only get a few guesses. In addition, the props are able to press a button to taunt by playing little sound bites to be like, I'm over here, you know, make funny noises to sort of, it's very funny. Anyway, we quickly discovered that the smallest prop available is a tiny little fucking hula doll, and people would turn into the hula doll and they would hide under fridges and other bullshit. It was such fucking cheese. They would just hide in places where no one could see. Fucking hula dolls. But yeah, it was good fun. I really enjoyed it, actually. Lulu, bugger off. You've had lots of treats and attention. She's next to me wanting more. Right. So put 100... There we go. 100 magazines of armor-piercing ammunition. 118. 9... what is this? Explosive cannon rounds. Ooh, I get flamethrower ammo. Evidently I do. Right, here we go. So the tank is now operational. So I'm just going to try and thin out this base down here. What would I recommend from the Steam Summer Sale? I don't know what's on there, I'm afraid. You might have to tell me. But RimWorld and Factorio are... Oh, Jesus. These things are tough.
Wow!
Good lord, they do not give a shit. This is armor-piercing ammo. They do not care. Yikes. They do not give a fuck. Right, okay. I might just have to deal with the... I know what to do. So I'm just going to quickly do a bit of a drive-by. Try not to get mullered. Oh, God. I'm going to get mullered. So I just ran over one of their spawners. And then drive here to the turrets. Bathe them in flame. Or laser. You don't have flame turrets? Oh, there we go. Lasers will do. Now I'll just wait here for my drones to come out from my roboport and bugger off over there to fix the wall. Fix me, you fuckers. So I just ran over one of the spawners, which will stop additional mobs from spawning. Oh, Christ. Fucking bugs. Cool. We're back to full health, yes? Yes. Thank you, robots. Switch over to my high explosive. Oh, cool. Oh, that's super effective. That'll do. I've only got a limited number of those. I've only got 6. Best be careful. Oops. Fuck you. Whoa, that's another big one. Fuck you. No one cares. Fuck you, bugs. Down to a single high explosive round. Okay, wait for my robots to fix me. Do I still have robots? 2 construction robots. Where are they? Oh, have I run out of... I probably run out of repair kits. I think I pinched a bunch of them, but let's build a few more. So I'm telling my suits fabrication facility to manufacture cogs, copper wire, circuitry, and then use those to build automated repair packs that the drones can access in order to build things. Right. Is this vanilla or modded? It's mostly vanilla. There's a couple of tiny mods to do with like how far you can reach and pipes. You can walk over them instead of getting trapped by them. Thank you, Viri Riviere. Thank you sincerely. Whoops. Okay, mining productivity research is now complete. Good. Lab research speed. It unlocks more efficient research practices. We'll do that. Right, so let's just thin out these fuckers. Tank has been repaired. Single high explosive shell remaining. Oh, those are just turrets. Okay. I don't care about those. That's all fine. Shit. Just lost 2 more drones. Were those both of my drones cooked? Okay. That should be... Well, hang on. The turrets might still nuke my... They could be a problem. They could still kill the... Will they? Thank you, Lorathar. Thank you, sir. Okay. I might need to wait for the base's repair. Oh, I could just fix it myself, can't I? Rather than rely on the drones. Thank you, Sizzles and Lorathar. Thank you kindly. Do we have logistics chests? We have some of them, but not all of them. So what Hexpress is asking is whether or not we have chests that are capable of accessing the drone network and requesting specific supplies be delivered or distributing those supplies to other drones, which is an important element of any advanced base design. Move, drive, 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 drive. Good lord, it's eating through the hull. Holy fuck nuggets. That acid is nasty. Yeah, ow. I need more ammo. Yeah, I'm okay for now. Well, yeah, high explosive, definitely. Okay, I guess I've got to drive and not sit in the acid this time like an idiot. Oh, yeah, look, they're still going to take fire. Drive, 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 drive. Yeah, it's better. Just be a bit evasive. Nah, fuck you. You can't get me. I've got a tank. Good lord, they really tank damage, don't they? Yeah! Drive away! Fucking acid spunk. Right. Ha! Anyway, for those just joining, hope you're having a lovely morning. Just chilling out a bit before I get on with work. Work takes the form of editing for videos that end up posted on YouTube. And, yeah. The guys are normally around in the evening. Most of the ZF guys are working right now. Thank you, Major Arsh and Cartman. Thank you kindly. Much appreciated. Thank you. Let's also order up a few green circuits. Where am I going? get about 200 of them. That's a pretty rubbish tank. Well, they're spitting acid, so... a sort of molecular acid. Probably MCAR. I don't think we have neither the ammunition being manufactured or the rocket launchers. You're probably right. Oh, yeah, I am out of ammo. Jesus. Ah, crap. Can I build a rocket launcher? Oh, I can. Hang on. Rocket launcher with two rockets. It's probably not going to be enough. Okay. Give that a go. Damn, it's nighttime. Just drive back to the entrance bit over here. I'm pretty sure I can just leave the tank parked outside. They're not going to go for it because it won't be generating... Well, with the engine off, it's not as if it's generating pollution or making any vibrations. It is just a piece of metal for the bugs. I'll leave this here in case one of the other guys would like to use it. Okay. Well, I have a rocket launcher. Hello, sweet pea. The dog is licking my legs. Hello, my darling. I know. You're cute, aren't you? Right. Why don't I stream the editing? A few reasons, Trax. Work me is different from gaming me. I'm chilling. I'm just talking. Work me needs to concentrate. You won't have me. How does this work? Sorry. Oh, I didn't mean to hold them. Oh, that was rubbish! Fuck. I need way more rockets. Oh, screw it. Let's just go up and get some fucking high explosives, come back and wipe them the fuck out. Sorry, what was I saying? Yes, basically I need to concentrate when I'm working, so I can't sit here with a headset, well, with this clamped-on headset. I've got to sit there, quietly listen to the audio, concentrate. Plus, it would ruin a lot of the jokes because I'm replaying again the scene again. I replay a scene a good 100 times before it gets close to completion. Just rewatching it, adjusting it. So if I streamed everything, then quite a lot of the jokes would fall very flat. Thank you, Less Than Pro. Thank you sincerely. And good morning, Social. ZF Social System is in the chat, folks. Feel free to say hi. Oh. Damn, it immediately ran out of plastic when I left it. Arseberries. I should have filled it up. It has sufficient explosives. No, is that the... Oh, wait. Did I put it in the wrong... Ugh. I just put it... Yeah. Okay. Right, we'll just wait for that to get sorted. And I would maybe make a few... Hang on, do we have any more? We do. We have 39 flying robot frames. It requires electric engines, and it's not getting those because it requires regular engines, so I'll go fetch those from a different part of the facility. Just going to replace the construction drones that were destroyed. There they are. Get a whole load of the suckers. Duckslayer says, that's fine. Your jokes aren't funny anyway. It's a bit mean. A mean thing to say. That guy's mean. Right. I hope you're well, Duckslayer. Someone's making cogs and placing the surplus in that box, but it's not a storage container, so, well, passive provider, so I'll make it one now. So that means that the droids can access that. Lulu, bugger off. Go get your chew toy or something. Does she have a chew toy? Hang on, so I'm just going to give her a chew toy. Sofa? Good, yeah. That is a dried pig's ear. And they smell of pig and they taste... Oop, and it's gone. Yeah, she'll chew that and it becomes sort of soft and tasty. Okay. Have you got it? Yeah, you've Yeah, she's got it. She's fine. Right then, so what was I doing? So I was trying to get some logistics drones into the network. Sorry, some construction drones even. And remember to keep a bunch for myself. So 10 for myself. There we go. Right, and then I was going to go down here to retrieve some engines from the research park. We were making them over here for the blue vial production. Don't get hit by a train, don't get hit by a train. Okay. Nuclear power. Yeah, we should start researching that. Definitely. Okay, here they are. Here are the engines. I should add this to the end. Yeah, hang on. Let's put down a passive provider chest again for the drone network. Where are they? Here they are. And put in a filter inserter and retrieve the surplus engines for the network. So if anybody would like to retrieve them, they're available and the drones can get them. There they are. So engine units. However, this area is not on the drone network, so I will need to build a single roboport, which is what I'll do now. Let's also request that the drones bring me production intermediate cogs. Bring me about 200 cogs at all times. Thank you, Quantum. Thank you very much, Quantum. Also, we'll add these rails, rails to the trash system so the drones take them away. A turret has been destroyed. That'll need replacing. Damn, without my night vision. Harder to see. Let's get it back. Yeah, a bit better. What's cooler, Thunderbirds or Stingray? Oh, Stingray. Because it's got Marina, Aquamarina. Yes, for those who don't know what I'm talking about, it's rather strange. It's a children's television puppet stop motion type show, which was weird because you kind of wanted to fuck the puppets. I wanted to fuck the puppets. Ha! Right, there we go. So engines are being manufactured. So take the surplus. Don't take, like, too much. And then I'll grab these engines and I'll go stick them over with the drones. Yes, so Thunderbirds. So with a bunch of men with spaceships flying around saving the galaxy? Saving the world from whatever terrorist plot is currently being concocted. Back in the, I guess, 90s when it was made. And yes, me and my brothers would always, we would fashion like cardboard costumes of the Thunderbirds. The sashes and the hats. And I would be Thunderbird 1, because obviously, you know, I was the eldest of the family, so I get to be Thunderbird 1. My brother would be, the next youngest would be Thunderbird 2. He'd get his own, I'd have my rocket ship, he'd have his big transport ship. Thunderbird 1, Thunderbird 2. And then the youngest brother, so Jack from the Culling, he would be Thunderbird 5, who's never in the show because he's on a space station, like, orbiting the Earth, answering the satellite requests for the Thunderbirds. I'm like, no, it's fine, Jack. It's fine. It's a space station. You just stay up there. We'll save the day. You just float in space and do whatever. He never wanted to be Thunderbird 5. Ah, the trials and tribulations of the youngest brother of the pack. The runt, effectively. I was a bastard. I was a bastard, big brother. good times. Right. Engines in here? Wait, that's not correct. They don't go there. They get fed into here, don't they? Indeed, I am the eldest of, so how many? So, what? I'm not entirely sure because my dad ran off and started bonking other women, but it's like, I think 5 brothers now? Not all full blood. Right, there we go. Okay, so more drones are being made. Cool. Thank you, Squirrel. Thank you very much. Is this an episode of Jeremy Kyle? I'm fine. It's all good. And that's why I drink. Right. Hang on a minute. What was I doing? I was trying to get ammunition so I can go and destroy those bugs. Do my brothers know about what I do? Yeah. Yeah. I mean, the thing is about the YouTube thing is that I would mention it on, like, the Christmas dinner table. And so, like, yeah, I've got, like, a YouTube channel and I just make videos. And at the time, I had, like, you know, fucking 5,000 subscribers or something. And they were like, oh, that's nice. That's nice. Well done. And it was only, like, then, of course, I did that Counter-Strike video and it all exploded. And I went up to, like, 1 million over, like, in 24 hours or something. It was crazy. And after that, I think... So my mother, in particular, was the biggest sort of U-turn. Because she was like, oh, that's nice, dear. But then when she started to understand what a YouTuber is, she got very, like, she's checking my numbers all the time. She's like, did you know you have this many subscribers? I'm like, okay, I haven't checked, you know, cheers. Like, you've just hit this milestone. It's like, mother, can you stop looking at my Social Blade account? Stop it. Oh, fuck. Need to put the ammo in the tank. And, yeah, what was the other thing? A little bit annoying. Fuck. Oh, dear. Ah, get out of the acid. Oh, don't destroy my drones. Oh, shit. We have low fuel. Oh, bugger. Bugger, bugger, bugger. Drive forward. Oh, no. I'm out of range, yes? Oh, that was lucky. If I parked in range, the tank would have been melted. Right. I ran out of fuel because I'm stupid. So, yes, the bigger problem is that my mother, and I reckon this is, if she's listening, I apologize, but you do this a lot, mother. She's very much like, how can you milk this? She's like, you should do this, you should monetize, you should do sponsorship, you should, I'm like, no, just fucking, just stop it, you know? Not everything has to be about, like, how can you make this about your own, you know, just chill, just enjoy the presence of it, but don't try and milk it for everything it's worth. I think it's almost certainly a generational thing. Sorry, I've forgotten why I'm here. I need fuel for the tank, which I can find over here. There we go. Yeah, but, you know, there comes a point. I get it. I know she just wants the best for her son, but it gets to the point where it's like, come on, you know, stop it. What is it she keeps saying? Don't leave money on the table. Don't leave money on the table. It's like, Mum, just stop it. Anyway. I know, Bion. It's just a bit annoying. Like, you tell her once and it's never enough. Anyway. I've lost the tank. What have I done? Oh, no, it's parked over there. Sorry, I thought it was here. Yeah, I think so, Akiros, yeah. Well, it's more like a luck thing, really. There we go. Two full 50 stack blocks. Firing high explosives now. Much better. Fuck you, bugs. Oh, I shouldn't go super mad. I've only got 18. Get rid of these suckers. Oh dear. There we go. Down to 6. Okay. 3. Cool. I reckon that should be good enough for now. We've thinned them out to the point that there'll be less of a problem. Fuck, there goes my ammo. Right, let's drag these over to the turrets. Laser turrets, do your thing. Take them out. So these are the perimeter turrets for the crude oil facility. Ow! Turrets. Their range is a bit sucky. Right, let's go park the tank. Well, let this drone fix it and then go park the tank. And go and focus on what I was trying to do, which is get green and red circuits en masse on the main bus. Okay. So where does the train track... So the train track goes up here. So what have we got coming in? So that's where the ore is distributed. So I'm just thinking. So that's the main bus for copper. So green circuits are... Is it just copper? No, iron as well. Right. I mean, what I'm thinking is that if I were to set up a station that would take away a large quantity of the copper and the iron to satellite facilities for the creation of green circuits, I might as well, before that point, set up satellite smelting facilities that just produce huge quantities of copper and iron. So I'm sort of like, I'm doing step two before step one by starting with the circuits on the main bus. But maybe for now, let's just have a bit of a stopgap for now. We'll have a temporary green circuit facility here, right? And I might squidge the red circuit, like I might go pop, 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 just like squidge it along a little bit over here. In fact, would that be easier? Just sort of squidging. Exactly, Elmir. It's a good idea to have green circuits just en masse. But hang on a minute. I'm just trying to remember my thought process. Why did I want to do that with green circuits? What was the purpose? It was to automate the drone production, wasn't it? And they will require green circuits en masse for their electric engines and batteries as well. So yes. Right. So batteries... Sulfuric acid. Okay. Yeah, so it's batteries and green circuits and red circuits on the main bus. That's what I think is needed. Right. So that's what I'll go and make a start on. So if you're just joining the... Sorry, meant to do that. Repair drone will fix that. It's fine. So if you're just joining the stream, welcome. So I'm just playing a bit of Factorio in the ZF factory that we have here. Ignore the pollution. That doesn't exist. Pretend you didn't see that. So we're here burning clean fuel here. We take coal out of the ground, then we wash it. And then put it in the furnace. And it's clean, beautiful energy. Beautiful. Lovely fumes. Oh. Right, where to start? I guess here. We'll just go here. Green coal. Yes, green coal. It probably won't be permanent, so hang on. So that just requires copper cables and iron. Okay. What I'll do is I'll sever that for a minute. So we'll do copper cables here. Okay. So this ammunition providing, armor piercing ammo thing can just be placed under. That's still connected? Just gonna make sure I haven't severed it. Yeah, we're good. Okay, right, so these will be copper cables. So a simple copper cable, just taking a copper plate and extruding it. Lovely jubbly. And we can produce those very quickly. And it'll be taking a section of this main bus. How much? Not too much. Let's take a quarter, really. Let's not go mad. So main bus copper comes over here. All of this can be upgraded. It's still mostly using yellow conveyors. Right. How much is being taken off here for the sake of ammunition production? That looks significant to my eyes. No, wait, it's only 25%. Wait. What is going on here? What is the purpose of this? I guess it's okay, isn't it? 25%, I think. Right. Okay, well, what if I took 20? What if I took a piece of this? That's being split there as, again, isn't it? Another 25%. No, we'll take it from the main bus here. Hopefully it's not a problem. So, split that steel, just so I've got some room. Oh god, Lulu, honey bunny. That fart is horrendous.
What is wrong with your anus?
Oh, Jesus, it could strip paint of 15 feet. Oh. French bulldogs, everybody. Right. So, yes, what was I saying? So we'll take 25% of this bus. So let me just get a couple more of these. Okay. Wait a minute. Do the circuits themselves also require copper? Green circuits. So just copper cable and iron plates. Okay. Pardon me. Wait, no, I can still grapple through it. It's fine. Okay, and then I will just build a big substation. Oh, I need to wait a few minutes for that. Do I have any stack inserters? I have one. I'm gonna need. Yeah, I'll put multiple stack inserters. Stand by. Some drones and some walls are being destroyed. Oh no. Oh no, who's done that? Fuck. No, somebody's built the walls. Look. That's dumb. Somebody's built an area where the turrets, they can attack the walls, not within range of the turret. The whole idea of the walls is so that they throw themselves against them and are destroyed by the turrets. But someone's just built walls, so the drones are gonna, right, that's why we're losing drones. We're down to only 14 construction drones. Shit. Let me go deal with this. Yeah, someone's fucked up. Where's the train? Is there one coming? I might have to run. Yeah, I mean, you can keep thinning them out, but it's better to have it automated. Just having the bugs get exterminated automatically. Also, we should get mine production automated, definitely. Where's the mines? Requires explosives and steel. We can handle that. Yeah, that's why all of our drones are getting completely wiped the fuck out. Because they're trying to repair a wall and then they've got no turrets covering them. Oh, more drones, more walls destroyed. Every time you hear that bleep, something getting blown up. Yeah. Fuckers. Come here, you spiky little bastards. I'll tell my drones to do it. I think I've still got them personally. Pull that down. Pull all of this down. Bring me the walls. Cool, I don't even have to climb up there. Yeah, they should just run before these defenses and be destroyed. Oh, is that one's alive. Gotcha. Okay, we'll just wait here for a moment. I've only got 10 drones, so they're going to need a few minutes. Anyway. Yes, so... Oh, dear. Fire noodle. Can I move this way to pull my drones back? They won't be deployed because it's too far. No, I'll take them all down, seriously. Like, if we lose turrets and laser turrets, it's fine. We can just replace them. That's what the drones do. But if we lose drones, then we won't be able to replace the turrets, and they just chew through the walls and chew through all the turrets, and the base gets destroyed. You've got to think about the long term here. Use the button on the bottom right to turn off the roboport. Ah, cool. Oh, wait. Holy shit. Oh, sweet. How cool is that? I was unaware of that. You can switch your roboport on and off. That's very cool. I love this game. Hi there, Fingorians. Hello there indeed, sir. Oh, and thank you, Mr. Fraggy and Squirrel Sammer. Thank you. Sorry, did I miss your subs? Thank you, guys. I'll just give them a minute to do their thing. Yeah, what else is going on this week? Not much, really. Just warm weather in the UK, editing the latest video, buying some fishing equipment, getting assets back from artists that I'm commissioning for the sake of a cartoon. And they've been very good. I've been very pleased. And, yeah. Not much, really. Thank you, Dershus. Thank you sincerely, Dershus. If I stand closer, the drones have not as far to fly. How many do I still have on me? Does it specify? I don't think so. Anyone yelling 3-2 green circuits to themselves? I don't know what that is. I'm guessing it's a ratio for something. Right. This will also help while I'm here. Yeah, very, very warm designs down here in the south. Just muggy heat. Right in this moment, it's not too bad. Oh no, wait, the sun's just come out. Okay, it's about to get worse. I don't know, Warlord. It's been a while since I played this as well. Cool. Let's grab everything and hoover it up. Thank you, Puffy. Thank you kindly, Puffy. Yes, it is, Elkar. So the sun just comes in and just cooks me. So did I, poet, back when I worked in London. I had an office, but the office had a had an aircon unit. So the moment I started working from home and I realized just how warm it gets in this flat. UK buildings, as in residential ones, yeah, they don't come with aircon. And they're big, thick buildings to stay warm during the winter. Many of them are very, very old buildings. I know that this street in particular, most of the buildings, including the one I'm in now, have certainly been around since, well, there's photographs of them during the Second World War, so they're at least that old. They're going to be older than that. I know this because I was looking at maps and photographs and stuff, just out of pure curiosity to see how much has changed. And the transition over from, you know, when cart roads were changed to car roads, it was very interesting. I was like, oh wow, they've widened that and turned that junction into a roundabout or whatever. And then I was like, wait, is that my building? I was like, holy shit, it's unchanged since, like, when was this photo taken? Like, no, it was like 1940. Okay, cool. So yeah, that problem solved then. So at least now the turrets can actually fight effectively. Now, would be good to build some mines. Build a nice big minefield that they can replace. But to do that, we need to automate explosives. Moved to Brighton 3 weeks ago for a new job, says Poet. Oh, really? Seriously? Hang on. Why do they have these shitty names? Who keeps giving them these weird names? I guess they're backers, aren't they? Yeah, we need clearer names. We go. Okay. Drones, just fucking take these walls, get rid of them. Stick them somewhere, I don't care. Ah, the greeting party has arrived. Deliver goods onto me. Thank you. Oh, bloody. Giant blue bottle fly has just flown in.
Fuck off!
Where's that can of raid? Hang on. Oh, fucking thing. this giant disgusting fly. Anyway, so I keep losing track of what I was doing. Yes, the green circuits on the main bus. So, where is that going anyway? Oh, of course, that's for the research, isn't it? Right. Mm-hmm. Could just send it that way, couldn't I? I'll work it out. I might move this later. So, let's get some stack inserters. I require more iron. Whoop. No, I don't, suspicious. I don't think I have a bot at all, really. Can't be bothered with that. Yeah, like a big fat fly. Don't know what you call them. Blue bottle? Yay! Nuclear power has been researched. Somehow I feel that might be a mistake, considering ZF and mishandling of a nuclear reactor can cause it to explode. Yay. Okay. Refined flammables increases the damage of fire-based weapons. Braking force for trains so they can slow down. Character logistics, lab research speed, follower robot count. Combat robots. Weapon shooting speed. Oh, robot. Oh, wait, that's purple. We don't have that yet. Increases the damage of explosive-based weaponry. Ah, the damage of energy-based weapons, the turrets. Let's do that. Right. Okay, give me these stack inserters. Line them up. Give me more. Why have I got so little copper? Hello, Lulu. What do you want, sweet pea? She's brushed up against my legs. Hello, my darling. Yes, you are a good dog. Most of the time. Ugh, gotta make all these circuits. Right. Oh, yes, I've got a substation. Hooray! Substation? Substation. Why are you licking my leg? I'm wearing shorts. I've got exposed ankles and lower legs, and she's licking them. Weird French bulldog. Let's spread them out for now. Let's just get the basics going. Da da da. Whoop, that was stupid. And then the output will be on this side. This will go down to green circuits like here or something. I'll probably put them in a line. Right. And then the other thing was... Well, it's just iron, isn't it? Okay, so we'll split off just a small piece of the... Yeah. Of the main bus for iron. Okay. Give me. Wait, green circuits there? Any going into a box? No. Just waiting for my fabrication facility to give me stack inserters, which I need. Anyway, how is everybody today in the chat? Are people at work or studying or what are people doing?
Oh no, it's an ambulance.
Use fast inserters, not stack. Won't increase the speed at which it produces, but it will lower the power consumption. Do you reckon? Will stack not make a difference? They'll be able to stack them with loads? Well, hang on. Let me see how many the machine can actually take. I could try one of each and see which one's more efficient. Just got your grades today. You're graduating. Well done, Cash Lover. Well done. Working, says Dan Jabanao. Dax says it's too hot. They're dying. Good, good. Waiting to go to the vet, says Dark Rush. Oh, shit. I hope it's not too bad, whatever it is. About to exercise, Romo. I don't like it. Yes, welcome to the club. Yes, indeed. Last day at work for Duck Slayer. Vacation soon. Ah, well, have fun, sir. Have fun, indeed. Moving out, T1. Ooh. Well, I hope it goes well. Yes. Cool. Well, there are lots of a variety of things that people are doing today, it seems. Normally, I just get studying or working.
Right, hang on.
Okay. So, what do you want, Lulu? Why are you being so clingy?
She's being super clingy. Hang on.
Aw. She wants some cuddles. Oh, cool. What's your weekend trip, Purple Tiger? Right. Oh, fuck it. Cancel. This is ridiculous. Just get some damn blue inserters. Thank you, Crazy. Thank you very much, Crazy. Ba, 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 ba. Good luck, Acid. Me too. Hope it's okay, man. Does she want butt rubs? Probably. She probably wants butt rubs. Lulu is a little attention seeker. Right, hang on. Let's have a look here. So, well, it can hold six apiece. So if I use the stack inserter, won't that be a better... Yeah, look. Yeah, he's just slinging a whole stack in there immediately. I think stack might be better. Don't quote me on it. I'm not making some revelation concerning min-maxing for the game. I just mean that looks better to my eyes. Oh, hang on. Hang on a second. Reading up on the chat. Right. Okay, so now I require additional assemblers. You need three wire assembly machines for one circuit assembling machine. Oh, yeah? Oh, we need more then, don't we? Well, I'll just start for now. Right. What's up? Sorry, just reading the chat. Was that Sally? You have too much time to waste on playing games and... Wait, sorry. I'm just trying to keep track of the chat. It's quite a lot of it. Sally Dog says, returning to calling me an utter wanker because of your easily influenced weak will and this game. It is now worse as was made redundant. Oh, fuck. That sucks, Sally. Sorry to hear that, man. Yeah. Good luck on finding a new job. Get your CV out there as best you can. That sucks indeed. Right. Copper wire, here. Okay. Move that out of the way. And then we'll just put a row of... So here, we'll just do green circuits. And I'll just call this a temp green circuit. Hang on. Yeah, we're going to need a much larger facility in the long term. Is that right? That's off. Okay. Thank you, Vapor. Thank you very much, Vapor. Okay. Right. And then what I'll do is I'll split off a section of, yeah, just a little bit of metal. Won't go too mad here. How to do this effectively, though? Let's do this. Probably should do it the other way, shouldn't I? Make a bit of room here. Okay. Oops. Thank you, Gary. Thank you very much, Gary. So like this is what I'm thinking. And then we'll take... Again, I don't want to take a huge amount. I'll just take a split. So that, I believe. And then we'll send this one that way. And then the rest can just rejoin with the bus. Like that. Yes? Thank you, Cash Lover. Thank you very much, Cash. Cool, like that. Wait, what? Yeah, it works. Okay, and then this will just link up with this. Like that. Oh, wait, no, it's the wrong side of the bus. Needs to be the other way. So what I'll do is I'll do this and just go like that. Cool. Right. So now we hook this up. Not hooked up? Oh, not hooked up here. So now we should. Now we need an output. Well, we need everything for this. And then an output for the green circuits. Pick up the iron. What have I done? I'll check it in a minute. And then this will be the one that goes down to the main bus. So how should I do this? We should. Is there going to be enough room? Yeah, it's fine. So like this. I just want to make sure there's a gap of two for any tunnels that will be required. Yeah, so this will be green circuit main bus. I mean, again, this is very temporary. Eventually, we'll have a proper thing sorted here. That's not right. What's wrong with this picture? That's totally wrong. There we go. Thank you, Tebow. Thank you, sir. I'm okay, Bert. And thank you, Von. Thank you kindly. Get some lights. It's quite dark. Can't see what I'm doing. There's iron plates on both sides. Oh, yeah. Don't worry. I'll sort all that out. Yeah, all that stuff is minor. That's just like just cleaning when you're done. Cool. So, good, good, good. Wait. Yeah, there we go. Cool. But yes, indeed. So, obviously, I need more of these white. But, again, a temporary. We're going to have a huge satellite factory just bringing in all of the basic resources. So, there will be ore going off and docking with a factory that consists of 50, 60, you know, of these in a row. This is just getting some green circuits on the main bus, basically. And what I want to do, because I just want to broadcast this to my friends so they know what's going on, is I'm going to make a couple of more conveyors here. Just so they're like, ah, yeah, that's the main bus. Because they can't read my mind. Yeah, this is why this might have to move like further over here. It might be more efficient actually if it were to move here. Okay, for now we'll just send it under. I'll make more of these. Hang on. Ha! Oh, hang on. Proximity warning. Two repair drones have just been destroyed. Damn fucking bugs. Yeah, they're causing massive problems to our drone network because they're trying to go from point to point here and they're just getting mullered. How many drones do we have? We're down to 9 repair drones. Has the train run me over once, frustratingly? Oh, cool. Energy weapons sorted. Okay. Research speed. You normally go for 1 to 2,000 green circuits per minute, says the real Doug. Yes, indeed, exactly. So, everything will be scaled up. Okay.
Sorry, I got
it. Sorry.
Pardon me.
Okay, and then once that's full of green circuits, people will be like, ah, that's what's going on. So all I'm the only, this isn't going anywhere. It's just to explain to my friends exactly what I'm up to. So when ZF log on, they'll be like, ah. More. Yep, just building a few. Thank you, Patty. Oh, wow. Thank you, Patty Berg. As always, you are exceedingly generous to me, sir. 495 subs in the channel. Holy shit, dude. Thank you. Yep, you're not an arms dealer like a Norwegian. I reckon you're probably a Saudi prince or something. Thank you kindly, Patty Berg, for your exceedingly enormous generosity. I hope you're well, sir. Please know that once you reach the 500 sub cap, you get sexual access to my butt. No, we're not doing that. I retract. Take back that statement. No sexual access to anyone's body. Right, cool. Okay, so, green circuits. Excellent. And we'll just go to the end and just make sure that they're all being provided into passive provider chests here. Oh, which requires power. Sweet. So, because they're all going at the end of the line, they're all just being shoved into passive provider chests, they'll be available on the drone network if they're requested. Hooray! Well, shit. Patty Berg has subbed 5 more times. Thank you very much, Patty Berg. Thank you for 500 subs in the channel. You're extremely kind indeed. No comment. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Soviet, my ass is open. No, it's not. No, we're not doing that. Thank you very much, Patty. And thank you, Mr. Sweet Banana. Thank you. Right, okay, sorted. So, for those just joining the stream, I've managed to get a temporary green circuit facility feeding the main bus. I need to do the same with Red, but truth be told, Red's position isn't great because, it's kind of far down. It's not terrible. I mean, consider that we're going to be building more in this direction over here. Once we carve into these bugs. Right. But yes, the next objective really is to get drones automated. So we need batteries on the belt. So that's the next step. So batteries, which are intermediate products. Batteries. Where are batteries? Batteries. Here they are. So iron and copper, both from the main belt. Sulfuric acid. So sulfuric acid will need to be pumped from the refinery or shipped in by train to the main bus, which can both be arranged, really. I mean, that's fine. So, don't get hit. No, we're fine. So, over here. Oh, has the music stopped? Sorry, bear with me. Yes, that's the end of the album. Okay, let's switch back to the other Hoover network album. Oh, Jesus. It's 10 to 1 already. Fucking hell. Time goes quickly. Right. So, temp drone, delete me. So, this is the main refinery where we're predominantly producing petroleum and lubrication. So, there's also... there are tanks being full of light fuel, heavy fuel. Not sure why or where that's going. So there are free stations for the distribution of more things. There's another free station here. So are we mass producing sulfuric acid? What does it require? So sulfuric acid. Thank you, Sweet Baby Chang. Thank you kindly, Sweet Baby Chang. Where can I see sulfuric acid? I think I need to put down a refinery, don't I? So, sulfur, sulfuric acid. So it requires iron, which we can get from the main bus, and sulfur and water. And sulfur requires petroleum and just water. Thank you, that random person. Thank you. Thank you, sir. So if that's the case, we might as well do it here. If petroleum is being delivered for the sake of the plastics, we'll produce a... Yeah, so this could be a good place. So petroleum is delivered here from the main refinery. Thank you, Azurica. Thank you. We'll make sulfur. What's this? Oh, just coal. Yeah. And thank you, Cregan. So up here, we'll produce the sulfur, which we'll use to make sulfuric acid. And we'll use that to make batteries, which will come down here and then rejoin the main bus. Okay. I mean, just thinking about that, sorry. Sulfuric acid is made there. We're using sulfur. Petroleum sulfur. Okay. Then the batteries. Just thinking if it's worth just building a new station for petroleum and putting it here or not. No, I think it's fine to just do it up there. Thank you, Panda the Bear and Cregan. Thank you kindly. Any vacation plan? Not really, I'm afraid. I'm just so busy. I'm just so busy with the bullshitteries and... God, I'd like to take some time off, but I'm just so... Got so much to do. Maybe. I mean, hopefully... Duckslayer, I don't know if you know. So I bought a fishing rod. I was going to start building fishing equipment again. As I did when I was about 14. So maybe see if I can go on a fishing trip for a day somewhere. Just get in the car and go to a fishery. Like a stocked lake, you know? Okay, so if petroleum is being pumped out here for the sake of the plastic. So on the same row, we may as well, we'll give it some room just in case anybody wishes to expand the plastic facility. Let's build chemical plants that will be producing sulfur using water and petroleum gas. So I'm going to need quite a few of these, if you please. So chemical plants. And did I build another robo port? I did not. We'll build a batch more. So make sure that this area is within range of the drone so they can deliver what they need. Okay. Aren't you allowed to fish wherever you want in England? Well, not specifically. Well, it depends. So, if it's sea fishing, then generally you can fish wherever you want because it's the sea. No problem. There is very, very few rules when it comes to sea fishing. Unless you were at the mouth of a river, where the river rules may apply. But across the entire nation, there are fishing regulations to do with so you have to buy a fishing permit. This is to sort of fund the... what is it? Like the fish, the wildlife and whatever it's called, the organization that sort of inspect for damage the environment and overfishing and stuff like that. So I'm just going to pop the music down a bit. So short version, you need a fishing license if you're over a certain age, and I think that age is about 16. However, there are bylaws concerning each individual county, and those bylaws can also specify specific things to do with their fish, their ecosystems. And for example, in the area that I'm in, which is East Sussex, there are bylaws to do with when you can't fish in order to just leave the fish alone and let them regenerate. And that's pretty much the case for every single province, county. For example, I think it's October to March, I think, you're not supposed to fish. Just to let them winter, let them breed, leave them the fuck alone. Fish when they're you know, hungry again. Yeah, wildlife conservation. Because it would suck if everyone was just going out fishing all the time and wrecking all of the rivers for everybody. And it also means that in the event of, oh my god, there's pollution here, someone's dumping chemicals, you can call them up and say, there's a problem here, and they can come in, you know. Oh, my phone is doing stuff. Oh, it's just a spam caller. Right, so here we go. Right, so sulfuric acid. So let's go then. Okay, so yeah, so we'll pump in petroleum gas and water, and we'll be getting sulfuric acid. And also, I've got those robots. No, they're still being built. Ooh. What's that? Sorry. A drone was just killed outside the wall. Right then. You do not need that much sulfur. Well, you know, better to have more than you need than not enough. Recently, you had a lake near you, says Nasher, that was closed down due to low O2 levels. They came in overnight with some quite impressive kit to fix it. Yes, indeed. So yes, it's good to obviously keep everyone benefits if the wildlife is all kept spick and span, as it were. I just need to wait for these damn pipes, unless there's some in the system that the drones can bring me. Probably take a while though. There's not enough drones. Oh, got a roboport. Good. Let's also make sure that the logistics network is properly in place. So I need to not try and fiddle with the roboports too much. Got to sort of build, work around them. Before they're doing important work. Whoops. Oh, never mind. Cool. So yeah, sorry, what was I saying? So yeah, I would like to possibly do a bit of angling. Just see how it goes. I was going to do float fishing, so the most basic form where you just you have a hook on some weight with some weights, and you just have a float and you just cast it out into a lake, and so long as you can judge the depth so that the bait is at the bottom, fish will be swimming around and float will go under and wee. Simpler than, say, fly fishing, which is, you know, obviously you're trying to mimic the actions of a fly. Or game fishing, where, obviously you can do game fishing with floats, but as in where you've got, you're trying to catch, like, pike or trout or salmon, you know. Just gonna go out on a lake. Just go, it's called coarse fishing, which is where you go for fish that aren't so interesting to eat. Fish that are quite shit and might be toxic in some cases, but make good fighters on the line. Things like carp or bream or roach. Well, not roach, but you know what I mean. As in, like a leisure fish. Build the nuclear reactor. We are not. No. The uranium is all the way out there, and we don't have any to really. Yeah, good sport, yes, but not necessarily. Apparently, they call the sports one game fishing, apparently, according to the guides that I'm reading. Will I take Lulu with me? I'd like to, but it seems that a lot of fisheries don't allow dogs, which you can sort of understand why. You don't want dogs jumping in the water. So I'll ask around. I'll ask some local pet shops. Some fishing tackle shops, if there are any that they know of that are dog-friendly. I'm sure that there must be some. All freshwater fish are eatable. Not really. Well, yes, you can eat them, Tails, but they can cause problems. As in, some people have tried indeed. Some people have tried to eat, what was it? I can't remember what it was. It, like a type of river fish, and they found that they had like severe gastrointestinal pain after eating them. So when I was about 14, and I was sea fishing off a harbour in Shoreham, I think it was, and I was just sort of casting my I was just fishing as normal. Anyway, I caught a type of fish that So it's called a wrasse. It's a type of fish called a wrasse. And more specifically, I believe this was called a ballin wrasse, if my memory serves. It's been a long time. And when it was on the line, I was sort of trying to sort of stabilize it and pull it up. It wasn't too big a fish. Anyway, so I went out and I was young. I was stupid. And I went to go and grab with my bare hands this wrasse. Don't do that. The reason you don't do that is because the wrasse has a layer of spines down its back, some of which are barbed, and I'm pretty sure are slightly venomous. Not massively, but certainly enough to get predators to fuck off. Right through the middle of the palm of my hand. Not super deep, but certainly very painful. That ended that fishing day. Pulling out this barb. Yeah. So not all fish are like super palatable. Some of them are don't want to be eaten. And some of them are covered in spikes. Take care, Tebow. What's it called? A ballin wrasse? What's a ballin? It's like a greenish fucker. Hang on. Ballin wrasse. I'm just googling it. It's been like 17 years. No. Is that it? No. I think that might be it. The one with the spines. Ballin wrasse. Highly regarded as a food fish. Oh, not highly regarded. Considered bycatch. No, I think it was that. Is this the one with the spines, though? Very sharp, spiky fucking spines that they retract. So that's the trouble. So I didn't realize, I didn't notice it had its spines retracted, and then it just put them up and I just grabbed it. Oof. Oof. Oof, oof, oof. Anyway. Any plans on returning to Space Engineers? We don't really make plans here in the clan. We just kind of play whatever. Why am I getting so few red circuits delivered? Too few logistics drones, I reckon. Ever had a hook stuck in your body? A couple of times. It sounds like, you know, you picture horror stories, but it's not that bad. I mean, it's not as if you have gigantic barbed hooks. They're just tiny things. You know, you hurt yourself more shaving each week. Yeah, you're not supposed to be using an enormous hook that sort of gouges into your thigh, because it'll hurt the fish. It's supposed to be a tiny thing, tiny barbless thing that just goes into the mouth, into the thick leathery mouth. Depends on the hook. Yeah, sure, but I'm just saying, generally, don't picture like an enormous sharp monster. Like, you want a small hook. Plus, if the hook is too big, the fish won't go for it. You know, it's supposed to be disguised amongst the bait there. Yeah, they're meant to be like, ooh, food. Not, oh, it's a fucking huge piece of metal. Oh, really, Rendix? Oh, that sucks. Yeah, the trick, just be careful when you don't be careless. Safety first. Alright. Put down another roboport. Cool, got quite a few drones floating about now. So, let's get this hooked up. Do I have the pipes? No, we're still making them. Cancel that roboport. Just give me the pipes. Come on. Good suggestion is to use fake prank maggots / worms of rubber. What, you mean like lures, Spritzel? Well, a better way, at least, sorry, I'm not speaking as an expert. I'm just saying in terms of what we've done. When we were on the harbour, what we would do, we would make a bait bag. We would basically take a plastic netting bag, and fill it full of bits of vegetable peel and just just breadcrumbs and just other bits of just food crap, and you'd sort of dangle it off the edge of the harbour, and this would cause like particles of food to spread out into the water, and of course that would start attracting fish. They'd be like, ooh, food. Other ways that people do it on lakes, at least I've been seeing in the videos. No, you don't throw it. You pull it out. It's on a rope, Pickle Tiger. You want to reuse it. Another thing to do is you get catapults. Do you call them slingshots in America? Yeah, like two sticks with a bit of elastic between it. And you go, boom, like Dennis the Menace. You don't know the reference. Fucking like to fling. Fuck, what do you call them? We call them catapults. Slingshots. So slingshot or catapult in the UK, or a jing.
A jing?
Australian. A Shanghai in Australia, a ketty in South Africa is a projectile weapon. Anyway, so yeah, flinging bits of bait is my point. Like further out into the water. No, they're called catapults in the UK. Right, there we go. Yeah, la. So I'm intentionally making this obvious so people can see exactly what I'm doing. Thank you, bandits. Thank you kindly, bandits. There we go. I'll just hook these up directly then. I'll send the water underneath. Damn it, it's already 7 minutes past one. I've got to get on with editing in a minute. Thank you, bandits. Thank you kindly, bandits. Right, so, water. Where's the lake? It's over there. Is there a fresh water source that I can utilize that's closer somehow? Water source. No, we'll just go to the lake. We'll just tap a fresh source. Okay. Right. I thought it was going to be a head-on collision with that train there. So far, so good, magic. Damn, another drone was just wiped. America has its own Dennis the Menace. Do you really? Thank you, bandits. Thank you, sir. Right, so pump. I get three of them, why not? I've lost it already. Where'd it go? There they are. Okay, so what I'm doing now is I'm just placing some water pumps against, well, the water. And these are going to be drawing up a fresh source of... Well, I guess it's just going to be a medium for which the sulfuric acid is diluted. Or sulfur, I guess I'm making. No, I don't know what this is for. Whatever. The recipe wants water. There we go. And then we're just going to take it this way. But I'm going to make some underground pipes. Because elegant. Like so. Fuck you, tree. No one likes you. We don't need your oxygen. We're wearing masks. Don't get hit. I'm okay. Fuck you, trains. Oops. There we go. Ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba. Yeah, Factorio is one of those time sink games, isn't it? It's like, what happened to my afternoon? I was supposed to do my tax returns. I ended up setting up a plastic factory. So, what do you do for a little... Yeah, what did you do all day? I set up a virtual crude oil drilling system. Like, yeah, that's nice. Right, I require some more iron plates. Does that work with pipes, Bear? I thought it was just pylons. Can you build bridges to skip across the tracks? I don't think so. Don't know why my voice went up there. I don't think so. Right. Oh yes, research is done. Thank you. Braking force for trains so they can slow down faster. Let's just have a flap over to the research domes. Cool. So some blue vials, but not loads. The bottleneck does not appear to be. Well, it's not even looking at the right one. Does not appear to be resource-wise. It's just the length of time that it takes to produce each individual blue vial. So we can certainly expand this blue vial facility with way more of these suckers. Ooh. Oh yeah, it does. That's easy. Cool. Okay. Right. So let's go and I can go this way. Boom, boom, boom. That was quick. Holy shit. That's what she said. Right. More pipes. I require more pipes. Oh, wait. No, I'm going to get mixed up. Shit. Have I done goofed here? No, we're okay, aren't we? No, I think I've done goofed. There we go. I've undone the goof. Right. Well, hey. Okay, there we go. So this row of what will be sulfur crystal producing refineries is now ready to go. They just require power and a place to stick the finished product, which is what I'll give them now. Oh, power isn't actually hooked up. That might actually help if you know you did that. Power provided. Get some fast inserters. Whoops. Ta-da. Okay, and then we will give them some of these. There we go. Sulfur. So, it's taking the petroleum gas, which is being delivered by the main refinery through this train, and it's splitting it between plastic and sulfur crystals, which I'm then going to turn into sulfuric acid, which will then be the base for the, batteries. Although I think the sulfuric acid is also utilized with explosives, right? Yes, sorry, the sulfur is. So I should be careful not to pinch all of it. How many of the ZF clan are playing here? About 6 or 7. Okay, so iron plates, copper plates, and sulfuric acid. Well, sulfuric acid will be the next step. So iron plates certainly will be needed to be brought up here. Okay. So we'll need to pinch those from the main bus down here. Sulfuric acid is also used in purple chips later on. Sure. Good to know. Well, we'll have some available nearby. Right. I mean, truth be told, I'm a bit out of time. I've got to finish this and go get on with work. So let me just label this so people know what this is. Battery production for main bus. So, yeah. Can I modify this? Red circuit temp, temp green circuit, plastic bar. Cool. Okay. So just markers for the other guys when they come on later and they're like, ah, that's what's going on. Cool. Okay then. Top one is missing water. So it is. Good shout. Thank you very much. Cool. And let me just stick down that and put it on the network. There we go. So drones will deliver sulfuric acid if it's requested. Okay. Don't get how he doesn't read any important messages. There's a lot of messages, D4Shear. A lot of messages. If I sat there reading all the messages, there wouldn't be any gameplay. Okay. Right. Cool. So, cheers for watching, folks. I'm going to go off and go and get on with... Yeah, going to go get on with editing. So, what's the dog... Look at this ridiculous animal. That was bred from a wolf. That thing. That incredibly inbred, fat, food-centric... creature. Right. Okay, so yes, I'm gonna go and crack on. It is the third week of work on the latest YouTube project, which is Armor Bullshittery Part 10. It's the second part of Part 10. Part 10 is actually enormous. It's actually like 5 pieces that are 12 minutes long. So I'm trying my best, but it's gonna take a while, and I'm just gonna go crack on with it and do the best I can. So I'll be back around 8 o'clock, which is when I put tools down and just relax for a bit, So yeah, that's what I'm gonna go do. Okay. Oh, pardon me, sorry. Yeah. Just gonna give her a belly rub.
It's like velvet. It's like warm velvet. Well, warm velvet that's covered in nipples.
So she'll spend some part of the afternoon just resting there, and then she's going to go off and join a dog walker slash dog sitter that lives locally. Well, it's not like a proper like career-based one. It's more a family friend that lives locally, and they own their own dog, which is a bit older. And that dog goes for its walks at around 4 or 5-ish, and Lulu just kind of tags along, which is helpful because it gets her out of the house and it helps. Teach her how to be a dog, you know, so she can have a bit of socialization that isn't stuck in this flat with me all day. Cool. Okay, so thank you for watching. Have a lovely afternoon. I'll see you again soon. Let me just hand you over to one of my friends. So who's on? So ZF. So Edberg is on. I'm going to hand you over to Edberg. He's playing a game called The Sinking City. I'm not familiar with it. So yes, wish him all the best. Thank you, Folkram. Thank you very much, Folkram. So this is Edberg, so have a lovely afternoon, everyone, and if you're in Europe, try to stay cool. So take care, and have a good one.